Hi everybody, thanks for coming back to 1minutedigital.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make the easiest logo in the world. It's so easy to make these shapes. These shapes are all built into Illustrator, and it's very, very easy to make a quick, simple logo for a letterhead, for anything you need to have your own customized logo. So let's start here with just the Sherlock Holmes logo on the top. And all this logo is a circle and a rectangle with some type on it. That's really all it is. Before we start, I do want to have a few windows open that we're going to be working with. So go to Window, Pathfinder, bring that one up. Window, Stroke, there's your stroke palette. If you don't see these options, make sure you click on the little arrow at the top and click Show Options. And Window, Type, Character. We're going to need our fonts open so we can type a little bit more in there. Okay, so like I said, it's just a circle and a rectangle. So let's go over here to our rectangle tool. Click and hold till you find the ellipse tool. Hold down shift, click and drag a circle. Make it a black stroke with no fill. And now go back and find a rectangle. Click and drag a nice size rectangle that's going to be above your type. And let's align them. So selecting both of them, go to the top to your alignment tools. And the second one over is your horizontal align. Just click there and that puts them exactly aligned horizontally with each other. Now again, let's see. This circle goes up just a little bit over the line, if you can follow that with your eye there. So let's hold down shift, click and drag it up till it just dips a little bit below that line. That looks good. Select them both, and on your Pathfinder tool, the very first one is Unite. Click there, and that made them one shape. Let's zoom in. Now with your black arrow, select that shape and find your scissors tool. It defaults to the eraser tool. Click and hold till you find scissors. And with that selected, hover over there till you see anchor. Click it and click it. And now move over to the other side. Click there and click there. And now we're going to delete them with your white arrow selected. Click and drag just that section and delete twice. That deletes the line and the anchor point. Select it and delete twice. Now that one is gone. And now we can select these and change the thickness of the stroke by going to our stroke palette and bumping that up and make it as thick as we want, change the color if we want, do anything here. Let's align these ends. See how the ends are very, very straight. Let's select both of those and change the cap to rounded cap, the one in the center, and that makes them nice and round on the outside edge. Zooming out a little bit. Let's see. Now all we have to do is type something in there. Now this font is, I believe, and I'll show you in a moment. Let's sample the one I did before. DK Fledermaus, that is a free font you can find online. I just typed the initials for Sherlock Holmes. You can do this for your own initials or for your store or for anything you have. Put that in the center. And then I just type the name underneath. And you just put it there. Oops, I missed an O. Oh, and you can see this one is spaced kind of nicely. What you can do is make it smaller and go up here to your kerning options here and space it out a little bit. Highlight there where it says VA with the arrows on either side and just space it out till it has a nice bit of space between the letters. That looks very nice. Move it up, and you can also select this one by holding down shift and moving it up. You keep that in the exact same place and move it up so it actually fits very nicely inside, and then you just type the address underneath and just put it there and size it the way you want, and you've already got a nice letterhead logo or a standalone logo if you want to use on anything you want. Okay, let's work on the next one, which is the exact same thing if you look at it. It is just with a diamond shape and a different font. So back on your rectangle tool, click and hold till you find the polygon tool. Hold down shift, click and drag anywhere on your artboard. Make that a stroke with no fill. Now go back over to that tool and find the rectangle tool. Click and drag a nice size rectangle. With the black arrow, select both of them. Up at the top, let's align them horizontally. Okay, now let's move it up a little bit because we want to imply a diamond shape here. So you want to have a little bit more of that showing. Holding down shift and dragging upwards will keep it in the same spot. Now select both. And over on your Pathfinder, the first one again is Unite. We can bump up that stroke if we want. And change color, do anything we want here, but we got to get rid of these boxy ends here. You can leave them if you like, but I like to have it open like this. It looks a little bit more finished. So let's zoom in a little bit, select that, and find your scissors again. And on each corner, just click and click. click, and then delete those sides with the white arrow. Select it and delete, delete. Remember, hit delete twice so you get rid of the anchor and the line. Delete, delete. Now let's round off those edges again by going to our stroke palette in the center where it says cap, round cap. And all I did here is put a D in there because this big open space is crying for something. We need to put something. And this font is Phoenix Script. That's another free font. I just stuck that right in the middle here. Size it up. Always hold down shift when you're sizing up type because it's going to keep it in proportion and it won't stretch it out. Then I just type the name of this fake company and brought it in there. Holding down shift, bring it in. Don't space out this one because scripty fonts don't look good when you put kerning inside there. It will stretch, it'll put spaces between them and it does not look correct at all. And you can bring that one up. Always hold down shift too when you're moving lines like this because it will keep them in the exact same spot. And then I just type the address and put that underneath, and that font is Eyeglass Normal, and you can find that online as well. So there you go, you have already another nice letterhead that you can use. Okay, let's get rid of that one and go for the Red Star Lounge one. That one's the cool one. A little bit of color in there. Same thing. Are you sensing that there's a pattern here? It's just a star with a rectangle. So over here, find your star tool. Hold down shift. Oops. That has defaulted to something else. Let's change that. Sorry about that. Let's get back to our star tool. Draw a star and then draw a rectangle. Make them a stroke with no fill. Align them. And now let's move our star. Make sure that the crotch of that star is not above the rectangle. Make sure it is just a little bit below, otherwise that'll look kind of funny. Select them both and join them on the Pathfinder. And there we go. Now delete again those boring old sides by delete, delete right on that anchor. Click, and then delete those sides, hitting them twice. And round off the edges by going to stroke round cap. That makes them just a little bit roundy on the edge. And make them thicker by bumping up that stroke weight. There we go. This one has a star in the center of it, so that's okay. Just go find your star again, hold down shift, click and drag a little bit smaller star. Let's make that one red by double clicking there on the fill. Pick a nice color, put it in the center. It's a little bit big, so put it in the center where your guides tell you it is, and then hold down shift and option, and that will center it from, it will make it smaller from the center. It's a little bit easier to see. There we go, shift and option, that looks pretty good. I think we'll leave that one like that. Maybe a little bit down. This is where you can have fun kind of playing with it a little bit and put it exactly where you want it. There we go. Now I just use Arial Black for the name of the lounge. Make it, holding down shift, make it long enough to fit the bar. And this bottom bar is not solid, it's dashed. So over on your stroke palette, choose dashed line and make sure the cap is at round and that your dash is at zero and your gap is at whatever you want it. You can make go up and down. See, I'm using my arrows here to go up and down and make it bigger, the gap bigger or smaller. And you can change the weight of this also here. So by manipulating the weight and the gap, you can make a customized dotted line like that. That looks pretty good. Let's hold down shift and move that up a little bit. Maybe a little bit. There we go. Now that's all centered. And then I just typed the address and put it underneath. You could do that if you have a letterhead, or just leave it like that. If you don't, you can also get fancy schmancy, make another little star and put it on the inside, bring it in the center, make it a little smaller. That looks pretty cool too. So you can experiment and put a lot of different, do this with a lot of different shapes. That's why it's so much fun. This one's a little bit more complicated. Let's move these out of the way. And this one is using a sunburst kind of a shape. And if you don't know how to make this sunburst shape, you can find my tutorial on how to make pointy edge circles in Illustrator. And I'm going to go through it really quickly here. It's using the star tool. You click anywhere in your artboard, change the number of points to about 50, delete what comes out. Now hold down shift, click and drag. And while you're dragging, hold down the command key and you can bring it in a little bit till you get a little more tamer shape there, and that's a sunburst shape, or starburst or a sunburst. And then same thing, just draw another rectangle, a boring old rectangle like that. Make them stroke with no fill. Horizontally center them there. And let's see, about halfway down, I think, you can place it where you want and then join them with the Pathfinder. And I know this is so boring already, you know how to do this, but we could delete those anchors because they're so ugly. It boxes everything in. Delete, delete, delete. There we go. And you can change your stroke, make it a rounded cap. It's a little thick. For this one, I think I just made it an orange stroke instead of a black one. Maybe there. It's a little dirty, but that'll work. And you can see there's another sunburst on the inside. Just find your star again, and it's going to keep the same tools you had with the last time you set them. So just hold down shift, click and drag, and you've got another one. Just make it a fill with no stroke and change that to a bright yellow maybe. And put that on the center there. Maybe, there we go. But you see now the bottom here is sticking out, and here it is cut off. Now you can cut that off by putting a white box in front of it, but let me show you how to cut that off very easily. With the rectangle tool, click and drag anywhere outside, and what we're going to do is select the part of that yellow sunburst that we want to keep. So click and drag, and we want to keep everything just above that line. It doesn't matter what the stroke or fill is, that's okay, leave it alone. Then go select your black arrow, hold down shift, and also select that sunburst, and hit command and the number 7. And that crops off the bottom. Actually, I did a little too low, actually. We want to, there, at that line, we want to cut it there. Command and the number 7, and there you go, it cuts that off right there. And I believe I made this one a fill with no stroke. There we go, this is a lot darker than the other one, but you get the idea. And then I just copied this bottom one, copy, paste in place, which is shift, command, V, hold down shift and bring that up, and that kind of covers that line. And then I just typed Sun Grocery on the inside and brought this up a little bit higher. And there you go, Sunny Grocery. Make that as big or as little as you want. Space it out precisely. And there you go, you have a logo. It's very, very easy to make these quick logos in Illustrator. And Illustrator is designed to help you make custom shapes using basically only these shapes that are in there. And that's why Illustrator is so, so wonderful and fun to use. I hope this was helpful for you, and I hope you are making your own wonderful, quick, simple, fun logos. And until next time, bye-bye.